Douglas the 52, Marler the 11, Fisher the 38, Dusty Carver the 9C. Roger Best the 07, Robbie Moses the 21M, Mark Vineyard the 4, Ross Bell's 87, Persley in the 09. And here we go, 10 laps to make the field for the Big Daddy 500 here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Marler way up high. Marler's going to go. Great job of driving by Marler and the 9 of Dusty Carver, able to miss him. That cost him, though. He's going to have to battle back. Remember, only taking the top 5. First lap in the books. Douglas, Fisher, Best, Marler, and Carver. Somehow Carver still crossed the line in 5th spot. That is the transfer position, but Mark Vineyard just took it away. Johnny Persley in the 09 already got some damage on the right quarter, but he is rolling. He is up to the 6th position. Ross Bales in the 87. Those Clover, South Carolina boys look like they're going to try to make it into the field. 3 laps in, going 10. Douglas out front all by himself. Fisher, he's got a good advantage over Roger Best. Roger Best starting to feel a little pressure from Skyler Marler. Marler going to run the rim on the outside, and he's got Mark Vineyard right behind him. Vineyard in the transfer position. But Persley and Bales are coming. 4 laps in now. Marler working the top side over Roger Best. Best right on the very bottom. Marler worked the middle of turns 1 and 2. Now he's going to go up top side through 3 and 4. Best on the very bottom. Can he swing it around on the top side? Skyler Marler in the 11, the PPM race car. Good battle for that 6th spot, and that could be a transfer position. If the 38 of Fisher makes it in, the 6th position would probably transfer. We save 4 positions overall for points leaders to get in, two out of each series, Ultimate Supers and Ultimate Battle of Bluegrass. This is a co-sanctioned race again. So 5th is guaranteed transfer, 6th is a possibility. White flag was in the air that time for your leader, Mark Douglas. It's followed by Derek Fisher, Roger Best, Skyler Marler, and Mark Vineyard. Vineyard safely in the show right now. Just got to hold on to it. Ross Bell is going to hang on to that 6th spot. Skyler Marler slides all the way out to the wall in the middle, and Vineyard will take over the 4th spot, followed by Marler and Ross Bales. So Marler guaranteed in. That's the top 5. Ross Bales is tentatively in, depending on the points provisionals. So Mark Douglas in the 52D picks up the PPM Racing Products Heat Race number 1. Again, 5 cars guaranteed to transfer, depending on our points provisionals, where those guys end up, whether we'll take 6 out or just see where we end up. Here we go. Getting ready to go green. 10 laps for our DirtEarn.com heat race number 2. Giffen quickly out to the lead. Bowles right there. Whoa, got the 4 car of Ligon. Ligon slipped up high in the middle of 1 and 2. Lost a lot of ground. Great battle for the 2nd spot between Stacy Bowles and Shannon Buckingham. Tommy Kerr, he's working up. He's up to the 4th position now. Glenn Elliott right up against the wall in the 5 car. Wolfenbarger in the 6th position. But the spot they want to be at, that's Glenn Elliott in the 5th position. That's your transfer position. Jeremy Hines in the 5H, he moves past Wolfenbarger to take over the 6th position. Again, he is your points leader in the Battle of Bluegrass division. This time by, it'll be four laps in the book, and Bobby Giffen out front. Stacy Boyle's reeling him in. They're working the bottom of turns one and two. Three and four of those drivers also working the bottom. Several of them are working a little higher through three and four. Tommy Kerr, one of them working kind of the middle through three and four. Five laps were in the book, coming to six. It's still Giffen, Bowles, Buckingham, Kerr, and Elliott. That's your top five and your guaranteed transfers. On the outside looking in, the 5H of Jeremy Hines, the 28 of Wolfenbarger, the 4L of Brian Ligon. Bowles again has narrowed it up between he and Giffen. He's right on the rear deck. Stacy Bowles trying to work to the bottom of Giffen. Two to go. Really sawing at the wheel, trying to find a way around. The 11 of Bowles working to find a way around the 97 of Giffen. White flag in the air one more time around. Bowles is there. He's to the inside. Who's going to get the better bite down the back straightaway? Bowles, good bite down the back straightaway. They're side by side. Contact between the two leaders. They'll bunch it up, but they keep them straight somehow. Bobby Giffen will come back to line. Bobby Giffen, your winner. In the dirtondirt.com, heat race number two. He's followed by Stacy Bowles and Shannon Buckingham. Tommy Kerr, and your last transfer spot will be the five of Glenn Elliott. They didn't want to take each other out, that's for sure. That wouldn't have been any good. What a race there. That's the way we like to see it here at Smoky Mountain Speedway, battling for the lead down to the very last corner. Crew is looking over the 22 machine, see if they can find a problem. Looks like there's something under the hood, possibly electrical. Fuel. Hear that it's leaking fuel, and that's not a recipe that we want to see. The four car of Vineyard, he's being rolled off and doesn't look like he is fired. But folks, here we go. We're coming four wide to you. It's a four wide salute to the fans. Folks, give it up. Give them a wave. They can hear you if you're loud enough. You see about 20,000 horsepower rolling down the front straightaway at a slow rumble. Ferguson's car has fired. Looks like they got the fuel leak solved. If one of our drivers pulls off the speedway before one to go, they are able to get their spot back. So Ferguson will still start on the front row. All right, folks, fireworks going off in the air. We're getting ready to have fireworks on the speedway. Donald McIntosh in the 7, your pole sitter. Chris Ferguson, the 22, on the outside. Ferguson out of Mount Holly and the 2011 Ultimate Supers champion. Currently riding third in series points behind Kenny Collins and Dennis Rambo Franklin. We're going to go green this time as we roll off of turn four. You see your flagman holding the green in the air. He's going to hold them till we get off of turn four. You see the chalk line. Here we go. Smoky Mountain Speedway, green flag in the air. Ricky Weiss in that seven car. He's looking for a hole fast already. Ferguson on the outside. He was fast in the spring but made a daring move and it cost him. Weiss cut down on the 53 of Cook. Lap one going in the books. Ferguson by a car length into one, followed by McIntosh. McIntosh going to hang on to the bottom. They're fanned out two and three wide. Got one, two, three cars banging and beating in the middle to the rear of the pack, but everybody straightens on the mountain, gasses them up. Kenny Collins in the 1C, rim riding it through three and four. Watch him down here in one and two. Looking to make some moves. It's still Ferguson, McIntosh, Weiss, Cook, and Arth. That's your top five, followed by Kenny Collins, Dennis Rambo Franklin in the two, Casey Roberts, and Mark Douglas, and Anthony Sanders. That's your top 10. The C5 of Crabtree just moved to the inside of Sanders for that 10th position. Ferguson and McIntosh, both in the XR1 Rockets, out to about a half a second advantage. Well, 2 seconds over the third place rider between the two of them. Ferguson with a half a second over McIntosh. The nine car of Dusty Carver has pulled it to the infield. The nine of Carver to the infield. The 101 of Casey Roberts all over the rear deck of Rambo Dennis Franklin, just about lifted him up down the front straightaway. Roberts in the eighth position. Ferguson slows. Ferguson, your leader, slows. He'll pull it off the speedway. Possibly fuel pressure again. So Ferguson in the 22 pulls off the speedway at lap 7. Tough break for the 22 of Chris Ferguson. So that puts McIntosh to the lead. McIntosh in the 7. He's about a lap or so away before entering heavy traffic at the tail of the field. Give Ricky Weiss now takes over the second position with Ray Cook third. Weiss fast all week long. Fast last weekend at Bulls Gap, Tennessee. The 11 car of Bowles to the infield. He grabbed up, almost collected the 11 of Skyler Marler. A lot of damage on the side of the 50 car of Shannon Buckingham. Buckingham riding in the 19th position at this time. McIntosh working it back off a turn forward. The tail of the field gets around Robbie Moses. Buckingham is next on his list, followed, and then Johnny Persley and Ross Bales. Great battle for the fifth position. Rambo, Dennis Franklin the 2, Casey Roberts in the 101. Rambo working the low side, the middle of 1 and 2. Roberts up top, trying to find a way around. Caution on the speedway. Looking for it. Here from Race Control, Series Director Kelly Carlton. Debris on the back straightaway is the call. Debris on the back straightaway. The ultimate official looks like Alton Wilson over there back there. He'll get the debris. Here we go. Green flag in the air. Ray Cook driving that outside in the 53 car. He uses the top side. Ray Cook to the second position. Kenny Collins also going to ride the top side. He's going to work it up to the third position on the outside of Ricky Weiss. The 101 of Casey Roberts also used the top shelf through 3 and 4 to gain a position. Look at Skip Arp drive it down deep on the inside of 3 and 4. He wants that fourth position back. Casey Roberts, he's sitting there behind Skip Arp in the 128. Kenny Collins, the 1C, looking for a guy one around. The 007 of Roger Best goes around in turn number 2. Caution will be back on the speedway. McIntosh will gas it up. Here we go, green flag. White's going to drive it deep into turn 1. Ray Cook up on the top side. Contact between the 7. That'll move Cook in the outside. 1, 2, 3, 4 cars involved now. Big accident on the outside as the 7 of Weiss and the 53 of Cook get together, forces Cook up in the wall, and then it just bottled up the field behind. We see the 87 of Bell's car involved. It is his race to start. He's out front by himself by virtue of being the leader, and he earned the starting spot. We're racing. Green flag back in the air. They drive him in deep in turn 1. Weiss all the way up to the top side. Skip Arp working it on the bottom. Weiss will hold on to the second spot. McIntosh rolls off to about a 3-car length advantage out front. Look at him, 3 wide back there. Tommy Kerr tries to take it to the very bottom. Kerr gets by Casey Roberts. Kenny Collins fighting back on the outside. Tommy Kerr is there to the inside. This time by 17 in the books. It was McIntosh, Weiss in the 7. Skip Arp the 128, and Tommy Kerr moves to 4th. Kenny Collins holds on to the 5th spot, but now Casey Roberts will work to the inside of the 1C of Collins. They're side by side off of turn 4. Collins able to hold them off with that momentum on the top side. They're wiggling and biggling through turn 1 as this track's starting to show a little character as they enter the turns. Casey Roberts swings her up on the outside through 3 and 4, trying to keep the momentum up. Looking for the traction, looking for a way around. Halfway down, halfway to go for your leader, Donald McIntosh in the 7. He's followed by the 7 of Weiss, but McIntosh has pulled away. He's got a 2.5-second advantage. McIntosh continues to lead. He's up to a 3-second advantage. Whoa, got one on the very inside. Looks like Big A Anthony Sanders may have got right on the berm and turned 3 and 4 with the left front corner of the car. Just threw a little dust. He's able to continue. Sanders in the 10th position out of Spartanburg, South Carolina. best battle in Speedway is for that fourth position. Kenny Collins still maintains it in the 1C. The 101 of Casey Roberts now trying to work to the inside of Collins. The 007 of Roger Best will pull it to the infield. 007 Roger Best to the infield. Casey Roberts has worked around Kenny Collins in the 1C for that fourth position. Roberts with now his eyes on the four of Tommy Kerr. Excuse me, that was for the fifth position. Tommy Kerr had made his way around those two earlier. The 09 of Johnny Pursley, slow on the inside of turn four. It looks like he's going to be pulling it. Nope, he's going to maintain it. Pursley will pull it off the speedway down here in turn number one. Johnny Pursley in the 09. Tommy Kerr slides high. Casey Roberts will move to fourth. Kerr's going to try to slip back to the inside. Casey Roberts kept him pinched down as they enter turn three. Casey Roberts will move to the fourth position. Ten laps to go. Now nine for your leader, Donald McIntosh. Working traffic. Works by the 50 of Buckingham. Thirty-three laps in the books. Going 40 for your leader, Donald McIntosh. McIntosh. McIntosh works it off of turn four. He'll see an outstretched hand. Five to go this time by. Just a handful of laps left. Field settled into a good rhythm right now. McIntosh, fairly clean track ahead. Next man in his sights will be the 87 of Ross Spells. Three laps to go. McIntosh with a 3.5 second advantage. Should just coast it around the rest of the way. He can choose his lines. White flag showing in the air for your leader, Donald McIntosh. He set fast time here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. He'll work it back to turn three. Coming off of turn four, it'll be Donald McIntosh picks up the win here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. He'll be followed by the 7W, Ricky Weiss. And Casey Roberts in the 101 brings it home third. Got the helmet off, got the Hans device off. Donald McIntosh getting out of the machine. Give it up, Smoky Mountain. Donald McIntosh, your winner tonight. Holding the big $5,000 trophy. We'll get in here and have a word with him. Donald McIntosh, your $5,000 winner here at the Big Daddy 500. Donald, let's get in and have a word with you. Donald, congratulations. Another great run. This place been good to you this year.
It really has been good to me this year. I hate it for Ferguson that he fell out. Man, we had a great car tonight. I can't thank these guys enough. Larry Garner, Blunt Motorsports. Thank Chad. He's just come on board. He's doing a good job helping us. Thank Dave, as always, and everybody that makes this team go. We can't do it without every one of them. Vic Hill Race Engines, Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, Stowers Cat. Just an awesome night for us. Got to thank the good Lord for giving me the opportunity to be here. So what a great night.
What a great night it was. Seems like out front, the clean air. We hear clean air a lot. That made a difference for you, I'm sure.
Oh, it made a real big difference. Even getting the lap traffic, I was having trouble just maneuvering the car. Just the aero means that much on a track this big, but pretty cool.
Big and fast. You're doing really well here. Congratulations. One more time, Donald McIntosh, your winner tonight. Congratulations, Ricky. Good run in the second spot there in the 7W. How many times out you been in this Vic Hill machine?
I've been in Vic's car once and this car twice, so we've been up here two times in a row now. And again, I just can't thank the Vic Hill crew and Krista and Sean and Barrett. And I mean, everybody, we've been working our butts off. And Eric back at the shop. And I just can't thank the guys enough. I mean, this car's awesome, and as long as we can stay up here and keep the car in one piece, and we'll be looking good. So,
gotta ask you, you and Ray Cook got together there on the backstretch. Just a racing deal, I'm sure.
Yeah, he got the jump on me the first time, and that time I think I got the jump on him, and I thought I had him cleared, and I felt him, and he picked the car up, and I could feel we were stuck. It sucks to see all that stuff get tore up, but hopefully his car is okay and race another day.
Hope so. Hope we both okay. Got a little damage on the rear here as well. Congratulations. Strong second place run. Casey Roberts, the 101 out of Toccoa, Georgia. Casey, good strong third place run. You came from a ways back to get to third.
Yeah, we stunk it up qualifying, but I got to thank Brian Ligon there for loaning us an engine. You know, he definitely helped us out there a lot, and I just got to thank you to him. My car owners are at Mississippi there watching the Lucas deal, so just missing them here this weekend. Third place ain't bad from where we started, so just got to thank Cushman Paint and Body, M&S Concrete, Schaefer Racing Oil, VP Race Fuel, Hoosier Racing Tire, Longhorn Chassis run good, Bad Boy Buggies, Penske Racing Shocks, just everyone that helped us out there. Just got to thank all my crew here, K&M Detailing, they doing all the work there at the shop and doing a lot of cleanup, so them guys want me to mention them, but yeah, I just got to thank everyone, my wife, and just thank, praise the good Lord there for looking at us. Hopefully we can have a good ride home, and just appreciate all the fans for coming out.
Happy Father's Day, Casey. Good run for you, buddy. Casey Roberts, the Georgia Bandit, bringing it home third tonight.